I don't think any character in the Star Wars saga went on a journey comparable to that of Ahsoka Tano. Probably not even Lucas or Filoni knew what this character would go on to do. She's undergone so much character development over the course of many different seasons of TV shows and other media. Still, some of the narratives involving her have many gaps that remain a mystery to this day. In this video, I will mention all these gaps and to some extent speculate on what is to come. Number 1. What she did after the events seen in Star Wars Rebels episode entitled World Between Worlds. After the season 2 finale of Rebels aired, and Ahsoka supposedly died, many still speculated that she survived the encounter with Vader somehow. How exactly they parted ways remained a mystery for approximately 2 years. Initially, all we knew after seeing Twilight of the Apprentice is that she walked down some stairs in Malachor. The shot was very reminiscent of one from season 5 finale of the Clone Wars, in which she chose to leave the Jedi behind. Sometime after the finale aired, Topps released cards with art drawn by none other than Dave Filoni. On the said cards, with very ambiguous drawings by the way, but it is to be expected of Dave Filoni, Ahsoka descended further into the temple. We simply don't know if Dave Filoni had the entire story arc planned out from the get-go and through how much iterative work it went through, but I suspect some things changed during the development process, as is often the case with such creative work. In Worlds Between Worlds, it was revealed that Ezra saves Ahsoka by using the power of the mysterious temple that somehow controls time and space. The entire arc is still shrouded in mystery, and I doubt we'll be seeing more of it anytime soon, which is a good thing, since time travel, in my opinion, has no place in Star Wars. With that being said, I absolutely loved how they handled it in Rebels as a one-time thing. Ahsoka goes back in time in that episode. She is savvy enough to realize that she can't go with Ezra, and instead needs to return to her own timeline. Next time we see her, she appears at the end of Rebels, sometime after the Battle of Endor. What she was doing during the original trilogy remains a mystery. Was she at Malachor all this time, or left at some point? I mean, she had to leave eventually, but we just don't know how long she was there. I do believe there is some story to be told there, and we will definitely find out more one day. Number 2. Her time as Fulcrum, a Rebel agent. We found out more about that side of her in Rebels, plus the Ahsoka novel had a scene with her and Bail Organa. Even young Leia was present, though Ahsoka never interacted with her directly, at least as far as we know. Ahsoka wanted to recruit people to join up with the rebellion rather than fight herself. She was tired of fighting after the Clone Wars, which is understandable. She told Bail that she is no longer a Jedi, to which he responded that she sure acts as one. They sort of reused that exchange in the Marta's sister story arc. I think there are still some stories left to be told, showcasing her involvement in the formation of rebel cells across the galaxy. Some people speculate that we might see her in the upcoming Kenobi series. I'm not sure if she has a place in that story, since I am convinced Vader will be in it, and this in turn has the potential to undermine the entire Rebel story arc, or rather contradict it in some way. But I'm not saying she won't be in it. It is possible to write around it. Number 3. What she did after the events of Victory and Death, the Clone Wars finale. The Rebel Alliance was formed some time after Revenge of the Sith and the Clone Wars finale, much closer to the events of the original trilogy and the Galactic Civil War. Even the very first Rebel cells were not formed that quickly. We don't know what Ahsoka did initially after the formation of the Galactic Empire. I mean, the Ahsoka novel explored that, but then the Clone Wars season 7 finale contradicted the Ahsoka novel, which I'm fine with, because they probably figured, okay, we need to tell this story and it is better, so what do? Do we tell a better story? or do we keep the continuity? I think the choice is quite obvious in this case. In my mind, it is always better to put the story first and utilize your creative freedom to its full extent. So, did Ahsoka stay with Rex, or did they go their separate ways, hiding from the Empire? I do believe we will get some answers to this in the Bad Batch series. Rebels did in fact reveal that at some point they did go their separate ways, and Rex has not heard from Ahsoka for some time. I do believe that this specific story beat was written in such a manner to elevate the emotional impact of their eventual reunion. Number 4. Ahsoka's relationship with the original trilogy characters, such as Luke Skywalker. Since we now know that Ahsoka was alive and well after the Battle of Endor, this immediately raises the question, does she know who Luke Skywalker is? The Secrets of the Jedi book, which is supposedly written from Luke's point of view, does share some information on Ahsoka, which in turn suggests that he was aware of her existence at some point. This book should be taken with a grain of salt, but personally, I think it is only a matter of time until we get a story involving Luke and Ahsoka. So much potential there that creatives are bound to explore. Stars need to align just right though, and we have to be patient. Perhaps the moment will arrive sooner than we expect it to, given The Mandalorian. Number 5. Ahsoka's time after leaving the Jedi. We got a good glimpse at what she was up to during that time in the final season of the Clone Wars, and I suppose I'd be fine with it if they never explored this again. But still, I thought it was worth a mention, and I think we still might get some stories with her during that time, perhaps in a different format, a comic book or a novel. Number 6. Ahsoka at the time of The Mandalorian. I think this is what most people are excited about, and we will find out more very soon. This might somehow tie into her time after Rebels. The big question is if The Mandalorian happens before the ending of Rebels or after. I'm guessing after, but it was not confirmed officially. Also, we have no clue if Ahsoka is still looking for Ezra in the unknown regions or already found him. Which brings me to number 7. Ahsoka's quest to find Ezra Bridger. We know that Ahsoka traveled with Sabine to the unknown regions to look for Ezra. This entire story arc will probably be resolved in the Rebels sequel, whatever it may be, and also include Thrawn and possibly Grysk. I believe that Grysk act as the new Yuuzhan Vong of the canon, but are rather different in comparison to their Legends counterparts. The Mandalorian might provide answers we seek, but I don't think this show will focus on that narrative. My guess is that Ahsoka will appear for an episode, two at most, and then go on to do her own thing, which we will find out more about in the future. The mystery box continues. Number 8. Is Ahsoka alive at the time of Rise of Skywalker? Since Ashley Eckstein can be heard in The Rise of Skywalker, one would think Ahsoka is dead, since all the other Jedi that can be heard are dead as well. I do believe that Dave Filoni teased on his social media that she is not necessarily dead. Perhaps it was an interview, does not matter. The Rise of Skywalker occurs 35 years after the Battle of Yavin, and Ahsoka was born 36 years after the Battle of Yavin, which means she'd be around 71 at that time. I'd like to point out that her being this grand, wise sage figure sort of diminishes Luke's role after Return of the Jedi, at least in my book, unless she will be alive and well in a completely different part of the galaxy, doing her own thing. Here is my take on this. At this point, Lucasfilm and Dave Filoni don't know themselves if she is dead. They might have some vague idea on where they want the character to go in the future, but it all comes down to other narratives that will come up in the future as they develop them. Who knows? We might get a show few years down the line with Ahsoka and Luke. as they write the story for that show and figure that Ahsoka should die, they might do just that. If it fits the story, that should always come first. She might also live, we don't know. You'll just have to wait and see. These things change all the time and are iterated upon. Such is the nature of creative work. Which of these Ahsoka mysteries that are yet to be told are you most intrigued about? Let me know in the comments below, and may the Force be with you always.